Let's see how you can build this one-page WordPress website for a local business using the Hestia WordPress theme and some of the best free plugins like Elementor and OrbitFox. Now, I'm gonna install the Hestia WordPress theme and then I will install the Elementor page builder. Last but not least, you can get the OrbitFox plugin too. You'll find out why later, so keep watching. After the installation occurs, let's jump to the theme customizer. Before moving to the front page sections, I want to change some of the default settings the theme comes with. The accent color to a green shade, for example, and the background color to white. Another thing you can change before moving on is the font family in the typography section. I will choose the Cairo font for the heading text to match our local website demo presented earlier. Click on Publish once you finish the settings and then go ahead to the front page sections in the customizer. Here, you can click directly to the element you want to change. First, you can upload a custom logo here. Then, you can proceed to change the text in the fields above the button. Finally, you will need to set up the call to action if you want it, and then remember to publish all changes. Anytime you want to see how your changes look on a mobile device, use these buttons to switch between devices. I almost forgot to show you how to change the background image. Even though it's not something hard to do, let me show you how to use this particular 3D-like parallax effect. You can do that with almost any image, and here is how you can do it yourself. First, cut out the first object you see with the polygon tool like so. I use the free version of Photo Filter Studio to do that, because it's lightning fast and easy to use, but you can do that with other image editors as well. After you finish cutting the object all around its edges, type Ctrl plus C to copy it, and then paste it back there using Ctrl plus V. Hide the background like so, and then save that new image as a transparent .png file type. Name it as you want. Then upload it in the customizer as the second layer like so. The first layer will be the original image, of course. Remember to keep the same size for both pictures and use images larger than 1920 per 1080 pixels. Click on this arrow to reveal the feature box content fields and then start by changing the icon. You can browse through all of those graphics, or you can simply type here to filter out exactly what you want. Once you find the icon you like, click on it and then go to the next option. The color in this case will be green, and I copy its code to have it later on. Next, change the title of this box and then enter a compelling text here, which I recommend you keep as short as possible. Do the same with the last two feature boxes, then you are done. Publish the changes and move to the next step. This particular section is populated with content by using the Elementor Page Builder plugin. To do so, we need to go back to the dashboard. Close the customizer, go to your list of pages, and find the page which stands as your front page. Click to edit that page, and then the big blue button Edit with Elementor. Once your front page editing screen will appear, scroll down until you see the About section. You will find it easily because it is the only section with both Add New section and Add Template buttons active. Now, start by adding a new single column section, then drag the first heading element there, like so. Set the color of the text to white, then change the font family to Atiti, Cairo, or whatever you want in the Style tab. Once you finish editing the heading element, drag a text element below, and then type a compelling About Us text in it. I will copy the original text from our demo to keep things going fast. Finish the element with some custom styling, if needed, and then move to the next one. Which will be the video element. I suggest you to upload your own video to YouTube, then copy the share link and paste it in the dedicated field, like so. If you want to have a custom thumbnail, you can upload it here. Furthermore, I'd prefer to close all these options to make the video element as clean as possible. After you finish all the settings here, update the changes to save your progress and go ahead to the next element. Remember to add a new section anytime you start building a separate element. This way, you will have them well organized and you will be able to slightly adjust the spacing between them, if needed. Next, you need to drag over another heading element, but you can use a trick that will actually help you work faster. Duplicate the heading element created earlier, and then drag it in its place like so. Change the text to whatever you want, image gallery in this case, and then drag over the image gallery element right under the text. Upload the image you want to use, set the image size, number of columns, and other options as needed, and then move down to the last element. Add a new section once again, and then duplicate the heading element. Change the text to Come and Visit Us, and then find the Google Maps element. Drag it under the title, change the location with your own address, and that's it. As a finishing touch and for a better spacing between elements, you can add dashed separators between each element. Start by adding the first one below the video and adjust it to fit the design overall. Now, duplicate it and drag it below the last two elements, one by one. One thing you can do before moving to the next step is to change the background image with something related to your niche. The woodmaker industry in this case. That's it, we are done with the About Us section, so let's move to the next step. You have a very good example of what you can do here by looking at the demo content that comes as default in this section after installing Hestia. You can change the content by navigating to front page sections and then looking for the testimonial section. Change the section title, the section subtitle, and then I recommend to paste a real testimonial in the testimonial content boxes, like so. You can add as many testimonials as you want, but three of the best testimonials you have should be enough. This section uses the Sendinblue email marketing service provider, which is very easy to integrate. First, you need to install the WordPress plugin as suggested and then connect it to your Sendinblue account. Stay with me because I will show you exactly what you need to do. First, remember to publish all the changes before installing the plugin. The page will reload automatically after clicking the button, so you don't want to lose your progress. After the plugin installation occurs, go back to your dashboard and click at Home link within the Sendinblue menu. Log in to your Sendinblue account by adding the specific key here, and then go back to your customizer and copy the custom code of your subscribe form to the clipboard. Go back again to your dashboard and paste it in the text editor of your default form. Click the Save button below, then one last thing you need to do is to go to your Appearance menu and click on Widgets. Once you are here, drag the Sendinblue widget into the Subscribe section and you are done. Check it out how it looks by going back to the Customizer. You may consider this back and forth process a bit overwhelming, but in the end, you will get this nice looking subscribe to our newsletter form, which definitely worth the effort. Everything is there by default, and one of the things you should do is to install and activate the Pirate Forms plugin, like so. After you activate it, the contact form in this section should look like this. Next, you need to change the contact info in the Contact Content tab by using the default WordPress editor. And then, finally, you can change the background picture of this section with something more appropriate for your business. I forgot to mention, but it's obvious that these three fields in the General Settings tab are meant to display the form title and both text lines above the contact info. Change them as needed, then move to the final step. Every piece of your local business website is in its place now, but you need the menu to navigate through them, right? So, how you can do that? Creating the menu, it's easy, and I recommend an in-depth tutorial about that above. You can follow the step-by-step instructions there to find out how to add these beautiful icons too, so be sure you check it out. Remember that you need to add custom links as elements to that menu, with anchors as links, if you want it to work like this. Every section of your local business website has its own ID, and you can find all of those IDs in the theme documentation, which you can access by clicking this link in the customizer. That's it, we are done. The one-page local business website is finished, and you can share it with the world. To make that easier for your visitors too, make sure you activate the social share option within the OrbitFox plugin, like so. After that, you can see these beautiful social share buttons on the left side of your screen that sticks to the edge of your screen, unscrolling. You may want to see 10 things you should do after launching a WordPress website. See you in the next video.